Fresh, clean and cheap. Strawberries grown right in our kitchen. Fresher than store-bought and cheaper too. Look at this big strawberry. Looks nice inside. Tastes so good. And it's even big enough to share. This year we followed the same tips we shared in last year's videos. If you want the 10 secrets of growing strawberries indoors, check the links in the description. The berries are clean and pesticides free. For breakfast, we enjoy them with sugar on fresh rolls. They are also delicious as dessert with ice cream or brownies. 8th of February, we planted from seeds like last year, but this time we started germination in a mini greenhouse. See a link to the germination video in the description. 1 month later, our tiny seedlings are ready to take their place in the NFT system. We gave the small seedlings some air by briefly removing the domes, while the larger ones had full exposure during the daytime. Once the plants outgrew the domes, we used the humidifier at night, using it less as the plants grew and produced their own humidity. At 8 weeks, we started removing runners so the plants could focus their energy on leaves and berries. The pH had risen to 7.2. So we added a little pH minus to bring it down to 6.3, ideal for strawberries. The leaves showed they needed more light, so we added a 40 watt Cosmoro bloom and adjusted the SF600 further out. Now the plants got stronger light across the canopy. This year we kept the lights on just 13 hours a day to reduce stress on the plants. pH was rising and EC falling, a sign the plants were using more nutrients. That usually means flowers are on the way, so we mixed a stronger solution. At 14 weeks, the first buds appeared. Flowers are on the way. At 15 weeks, the flowers had arrived. Time to pollinate. In the comments on last year's strawberry video, someone reminded us, making buzzing sounds like a bee. So here we go. If you don't pollinate well, the berries won't form. Remember, pollinate every flower every day as long as there are flowers. Just a week later, the first green berries began to form. By week 17, most of the flowers had turned into green berries, and one was already growing big. Only 5 days later, our first ripe berry was ready to eat. And it weighed 27 grams. Looks nice. Once the berry started forming, the pH began to drop faster. In fact, last year we noticed the same trend already during flowering. Either way, when fruiting begins, be ready to adjust pH back up several times a week. When strawberries start making fruit, they take up more nitrate. That makes the water more acidic, so you need to raise the pH more often. At 19 weeks, we picked our first small harvest of strawberries. We slice them open on the cutting board, and inside they look just as good as they tasted. Just 3 days later, even more berries were ready to be picked. This time there were enough for dessert for two. Strawberries with vanilla sauce. Yummy! We add tap water. When the berries are red, they drink a bit more. We kept the scale and notebook nearby, so it was easy for the kids and us to pick just one or two fresh berries, weigh them, and enjoy them right away. We weighed every harvest. This year we picked 3,529 grams, almost the same as last year. That's about 9 baskets of 400 grams each. At store prices, that would cost around $64. So, what's the cost for 400 grams of homegrown berries? From February 8 to March 8, we ran 2 20-watt Cosmoro lights for 16 hours a day. From March 9th to April 13, we ran 1 74-watt Spider Farmer 13 hours a day. And from April 14th to September 5th, we ran the 74-watt plus a 40-watt Red LED, also 13 hours a day. We calculated costs using the monthly average power price. And then for each month, we multiplied the light's power by the number of hours it was on and the number of days to get the energy used, and multiplied that by the electricity price to find the monthly costs. The table shows the price per kilo or liter and the estimated cost of the amounts we used of crystalline indigo, calcinit, and pH+. 400 grams costs 27.1 Norwegian kroner, or about $2.75. Even indoors, pests can find a way in. These spider mites likely came from outside. We keep windows open, go in and out to the garden, and even our cats can carry them in. It took months before we even saw any spider mites, and we still had an amazing harvest. We enjoyed berries for months, but we recommend giving bigger strawberry plants more space than these NFT channels if you want to grow and pick strawberries all year round. Well, as long as you don't get or can handle the spider mites. Good luck!